Hello everyone, today we're going to be talking about Dos Cabezas by Basquiat and how it ignited a friendship between Andy Warhol and Basquiat, which led to many future collaborations. But first, let's talk about Basquiat's humble beginnings, which led to his legacy. Jean-Michel Basquiat was born in Brooklyn, New York in 1960. His father was from Haiti and his mother was from Puerto Rican descent. Because of this, he was fluent in English, Spanish, and Haitian. He started drawing at a very young age, and he was very passionate. He often used the paper that his father brought back from his accounting firm. Many of his drawings were using cartoons from television shows that he watched, and his mother was a big influence because she always pushed him to keep drawing. When Basquiat was 7 years old, he was hit by a car while playing in the street and was hospitalized. While recuperating, his mom bought him Grey's Anatomy drawing book, where he drew inspiration for many of his future works. This book was a foundation for Basquiat's work, where he was intrigued about the human body and how it was broken down by lines and parts. And as you can see in his early sketches, many of these concepts were incorporated. At the age of 17, Basquiat's father kicked him out the house because he dropped out of high school, and Basquiat began to support himself by selling t-shirts and homemade postcards. Basquiat and his classmate, Al Diaz, began spray painting poetry and symbols all over Lower Manhattan, signed Same Old, representing a corporate logo and the phrase, same old shit. The messages caught on, and this alter ego began to grow very popular. Samuel's messages soon began to appear all over important art galleries and nightclubs, and was very recognized. After a disagreement with his longtime friend, however, Al Diaz, Basquiat decided to kill off the Samuel's movement with Samuel's is Dead, and then that was the end of it. Basquiat was very knowledgeable of various art styles and movements and would often mix everything he could. He was also very aware of his culture and often adapted this into his expressionist art style. Creating these multiple layers was a collage technique he used to create depth and complexity in his work. Besides painting on paper or stretched canvas, Basquiat often painted on materials he found in the streets, such as windows, doors, scraps of foam rubber, which he daunted together with wooden bars and hinges. He covered the surfaces with paint and pieces of torn, crumpled paper superimposed on top of one another. His choice of media and material is a reflection of his interest in mixing different methods of expression. Basquiat first met Andy Warhol dining in a restaurant with curator Henry Gelzeiler, and sold Andy Warhol a couple of his postcards. Basquiat then left the lunch and came back in an hour with a complete painting of the Polaroid he just took with Warhol in the restaurant. The painting is known as Dos Cabezas. Dos Cabezas is an original work by Basquiat and was acrylic and oil stick on canvas mounted on tied wood supports, 152 by 152 centimeters. Dos Cabezas really shows Basquiat's impressive speed and memory, and Basquiat uses bright colors to bring the painting together, and he does this by smearing paint in very quick and confident brushstrokes. As quoted by Andy Warhol, "I took the Polaroid and went home. Within 2 hours, a painting was back, still wet of him and me together. And I mean, I'm just getting it to Christie Street must have taken an hour. He told me his assistant painted it." This painting, Dos Cabezas, ignited a friendship between Andy Warhol and Basquiat, which led to many collaborations in the future. The impression Basquiat gave Andy Warhol led to the film called Downtown 81, which included music from Basquiat, who was surprisingly also a musician. At the time of the movie, Basquiat was homeless and slept in the production office during most of the shooting. The film really highlights his life traveling downtown Manhattan and selling his paintings. It shows the struggles Basquiat went through and how he never stopped believing in his art. Basquiat and Andy Warhol were a very rare duo. Basquiat was like the cool kid of the 80s, and Andy Warhol was the king of pop art. Many didn't approve of the relationship between the two because they speculated that they were just using each other for fame. This is because they felt that Basquiat just wanted the approval from the traditional art world, while Andy's art wasn't selling well in the 80s, so he just wanted to ride on Basquiat's new wave. After receiving mostly bad reviews from the press on their collaborations, Basquiat left New York hurt and depressed. This is because Basquiat felt like he failed Andy Warhol, who he looked up to as a father figure. Unfortunately, the two would never make amends, and Andy Warhol would die in February 22nd of 1987. This negatively affected Basquiat, who began developing drug problems. In conclusion, Dos Cabezas represents new beginnings. Because Basquiat ran into the studio to create this piece and came back to Andy Warhol just in time, he was really able to impress him with his speed and his memory. Andy Warhol was already an icon at the time, and collaborating with Basquiat really benefited both of them. Unlike his other paintings, the fact that he was able to paint under pressure under an hour to create a masterpiece speaks volumes on the potential that he had as an artist. This can be vividly seen with the aggressive marks and brushstrokes on the canvas. Despite overall his success, Basquiat died very young of a drug overdose on August 12, 1988 in New York City. He was 27 years old.